Hello everybody. So I am here to present my paper as a research demo for iGlue, which is a non-invasive device for continuous glucose measurement with IOMT network. Actually, this work is an extended abstract of our previously published article in a IEEE consumer electronics magazine. So it is basically a measurement device which is non-invasive to measure blood glucose. Now, diabetes patients have been doubled from last few decades. Around 422 million diabetic patients that we have around the world. Now, there is a requirement to design some smart solution to help them so that they can measure their blood glucose continuously and they can actually do some diet plan accordingly. There is no smart healthcare device still available in the market. So, we have designed such kind of device where you can use it multiple times in a day, and at the same time, it can help you to measure the accurate value. So, our proposed non-invasive iGlue device is being integrated in the IOMT framework to provide a state-of-art solution for a smart healthcare. So diabetes patients can measure it multiple times in a day. So it can be useful for any diabetic patient, type 1, type 2. Any diabetes patient can use. So this is the structure diabetes patients in the globally. Figure is increasingly rapidly nowadays. It is expected to reach around 700 million at the end of the 2045. Now, what is the need of the blood glucose measurement for a continuous? Ultimately, if you are a diabetic patient, then probably you need to plan your diet according to whatever your blood glucose. So this device will help you to go for a frequent measurement, and it gives very accurate reading in the range of 80 to 420. So it works for all kind of patient. So traditional approach where we are measuring through some sort of HD check of device glucometer, which is available in the market, which basically measure the capillary glucose. However, serum glucose is always considered to be an accurate one for a diabetes patient, and that is also being prescribed by worldwide doctor. So actually, our solution is providing a more accurate, which is equivalent to your serum glucose measurement for a diabetes patient. So this is just a vision that we would like also make to secure with the insulin control automatically with this particular device. So it is a low cost and high accurate solution to measure the blood glucose of all kind of people. The device is user friendly and it is easily operated for a smart healthcare purpose. The proposed device is using the concept of NI spectroscopy with multiple short wavelength. The device is implemented three channel where we have considered the reflection and absorption spectroscopy of 940 nanometer and absorption spectroscopy of 100. So this way, using the optical measurement approach, the eye is very accurate. Now this is basically a flow for a eye where we useful with the proper optimizing a machine learning model. So here we are using a regression model to accurately predict the blood glucose value. Basically, we have collected the database of a few people by following the medical protocol, and with that we have trained our device, and then through a regression we are predicting the value. So as I said, that it is based on NIH spectroscopy and 3-channel device. So basically we have used a DNN model in order to predict the blood glucose value. Okay, so once the data has been logged through a logger, then we are applying a coherent variable, basically stabilize one particular value, then DNN is being applied to predict the model. The sigmoid activation for DNN is considered, and we have used the 10 hidden layer for a DNN network. So output of the one neuron of hidden layer is the input to the next layer, and this way we have considered these stages, and the output value is basically in terms of the mg per dl. Now the accuracy is being validated with the at the same time through a SD check glucometer, which is being used, and we have basically find out some quantified measurement value with this. So DNN 10 is being applied. So we have used the LED detector and ADC with the filtering capability and frame acquisition controllability. This component are embedded on a single two-layer PCB to have a portable continuous glucose measurement. So we collected around 500 samples, and from those 500 samples, 17% of the samples we have used for a training purpose, and 30% we have used for the training purpose, testing purpose. So the data is collected with the help of 16-bit ADC with sampling rate of 128 samples per second. The PCB has an infrared emitter and detector. We have used the Atmega microcontroller for a processing. So this is the prototyping module where we have used a 3-channel. So this is actually a tutorial presentation where through which we are actually making our values. So work present a novel non-invasive device for a continuous glucose measurement for a smart healthcare. NIH-based specific wavelength is being applied for a device prototyping, and it is being calibrated and validated for all kind of subject. And we have used a deep neural network to accurately predict the value. Now I am just showing our device and demo.
Hello, all of you. I am here to present a demo of IQ. So, if you just look at that, this is my module. So, this is RD for the processing. This is my acquisition module. This is a 4-channel acquisition module that we are using for our purpose. So, if you look at this, then here we have a 3-channel. Okay. So, I am just putting my finger in order to capture the data. So I am just putting my finger like this. You can observe that I have put my finger like this to this particular module, and now it will capture the value. I am just switching to the Arduino IDE environment where actually the value is being captured. Data terminal. Terminal is about that this value is being captured. These values are 3-channel value. So first, second, third value is you need to ignore because this is actually we have used the 4-channel ADC, but our 3-channel is not useful. Our ADC is in first, second, and fourth channel. But this 4-channel value is being monitored
written over here. So if you observe that this is for channel 1, channel 2, channel 3. This way, the value is being captured. Okay. And from this, we are sending this 3 channel value to our regression model. The regression model will run. And according to that, the value will be predicted value will be generated. The predicted value is being defined over here. This value is in the index of mg per dl. Okay, so this way we have connected so many samples and also with the predicted value. Now, whatever the samples that we have collected, out of those 70% we have used for a training purpose and 30% are from the testing purpose. And here, if you observe that this particular module that we are talking about, this is very compact and it is very portable. You can actually carry out it anywhere. And the accuracy level is also very high.